concert and community team band. I'd like to ask our vice principal, Mr. McAllister, to throw a few more stones on the fire and we can get the evening underway. The first band is, we have a number of groups, wide variety of talents. The first band is a junior band conducted by Mrs. Irina Thompson.
Good evening, everyone. To open this year's spring concert, junior band is ready for you, and we're ready to open up with Fine and Deadly. Will be introduced by the student who already graduated from OAC music program last year. He still participates in working with younger group, exploring quite different avenues of music making, and one of which is conducting. Please welcome Morosco Lett.
Okay, good evening, everyone. The piece we're going to play for you is Canal Street Clam Bake. It's arranged by John Edmondson, and it's played in the Dixieland style, and it features a combo within the band. Now, our combo consists of seven musicians. On flute will be Heather McLean, clarinet, Jennifer Earle, tenor sax, Andrew Kennedy, trumpet, Mark Fitzgerald, trombone, Emily Alexander, and on tuba, Steve Bertram, and on drums, Marvin Ferrero. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
For our last selection, as a junior band in front of you, we're going to finish up with Royal and Blanc.
Junior band is made up of grade 9s and 10s. Some of them have only been playing for a matter of months. And we now will bring Mrs. Tomczyk back up to honor some of those who deserve an award.
Junior Participation Awards to two students who are leaving the junior program, going to better things and higher things in our senior music program. These students exemplify extreme leadership, participation, and musical excellence. I would like to ask Mr. McAllister to present his awards. Would Heather McLean and Andrew Kennedy come up to the front?
There are many staff members involved in the music department, and whether they actually teach music or not, we have the vocal class coming up, and Ms. Corcoran will tell you all about it.
Good evening. I would like to introduce you to the vocal class, who very recently were responsible for putting on a very successful coffee house night, and they very generously donated all the proceeds to Share Life, $350. We probably do a type of more contemporary music in the vocal class. We're going to be singing a song today called Lean On Me. And we'd also like to thank our very talented musicians. We have Cherie Jensen on piano, and Marasco Lett on drums, who've helped us out an awful lot. We've got our own vocal class participant, Jason, on for this.
That you can't carry on.
That was Miss Margaret Corcoran in the vocal class. Next we have the Dixieland Band. As you can see, we all have hats. I don't want to wear mine, I'll mess my hair up. Dixieland is a music style from the 1920s. You heard some from the junior band. At this time, music was not only bearable, but became actually fun and exciting, at least in my opinion. We have two numbers to play for you. The first one is called Honeysuckle Rose, composed in 1929 by Thomas Fats Waller. And in a moment, we'll begin it. We have Scott Williams, who will begin with a solo. We also have Wayne Tan singing, and Kim O'Shawn solo as well.
Thank you.
This band is comprised mainly of senior students. We have Jason Lill on trumpet, Kim Beauchamp on clarinet, Scott Williams on tenor sax, Eric Goodrich, whose primary instrument is French horn, but he's doing us a favor by playing trombone. Thank you, Eric. We also have some fellow named Mr. Tisdale on piano, helping us out. And marvelous Marvin Barrera, grade 10 student on drums, with Wayne Temple. Our final selection is When the Saints Go Marching In. I don't know who composed it. I don't know when it was written. I don't even know if that can be found out. It may be divinely conceived. And here we have Wayne Tan in garb to help sing it and join in with him. You all know the words. When the Saints Go Marching In.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was a song choose by Clemens Nonpapa, called Nonpapa because there was a pope at the same time by the name of Clement. He wasn't very musical, so they called the musician Nonpapa. That will open our program. We sing in San Antonio, and we're singing another Renaissance number. And of course, it has to be a Spanish Renaissance number in San Antonio. We're going to sing El Grillo by the high Renaissance composer Josquin de Berg. The next song we're going to sing is in French. It's by Georgine Stachy, who is a protege of the great chanteuse Edith Piaf, Le Temps de Vivre. We're going to sing two American folk songs. They're interesting folk songs in that they were written by the Englishman John Rutter, Soldier Boy and Fiddlerman.
Thank you.
As you know, Mr. Tisdale does a lot for this department. He even arranged Texas weather for these students here this evening, just to see if they'll be prepared for next week. Yes. Take a bow, Brian. We now have the vocal awards announced by Mr. Brian Tisdale and presented by Marian Speciale, our vice principal.
This year, we have two people receiving vocal awards. These awards are given to students, usually who are graduating from the program, who have contributed to the choral music and vocal music and singing in the school. First person, very fine singer, has been in the choir, I believe, since grade 9, Natalie Rodriguez. Speciale, I'd like to introduce the other person who is to receive the Vocal Music Award for 1990. It's a young man who came into the choir when he had maybe one, maybe two men in the choir. Has been a person who's encouraged others to join, and you'll hear lots from this person and others tonight. Wayne Tan.
By the way, during the Dixieland Band performance, I failed to mention two people's names. On bass was Jennifer Lagdapon, and myself, Tom Selleck. Frank Whitman, sorry. We now have a special presentation. A part of the cast from this year's school play, Fame, have a short promotional presentation. We have four students coming up. Michael Wise is playing the part of Mr. Farrell, the drama teacher. Kenneth Cronin is playing the part of Mr. Shorofsky, the music teacher. Erin McNamara is playing Mrs. Sherwood, the English teacher. And Lisa Fina is Miss Berg, the dance teacher. The play is May 16th and 17th, Wednesday and Thursday, at the Heritage Theater in downtown Brampton. So again, the four students up here.
My name, Mr. Shorofsky, and this is music class. Too much sleep, that's not good for artists. For if you love music, you must give up something, because music is the hardest profession in the world.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Sherwood. As your English teacher, I just want to get something very clear. You're not getting off easy just because you're talented. I don't care how well you dance or how cute you are. If you don't give your academic subjects equal time, you're out.
Welcome to the dance department. My name is Miss Burr. Dance is not a way of getting through school. It is a way of life plus school, and the school part is easier. You all want fame? Well, fame costs. And right here is where you start paying.
Sometimes I wonder where I've been. Who Test.
Hi. Peter, Petrucci just told me to stall, so I'm going to read what he gave me earlier. The next group up is a peculiar name, Fuzzy Dice. Stalled about 10 seconds. Their members are Daniel Martinick, nicknamed Crash, referring to his driving record. Peter Petrusa, Doctor. Mike Adante, Narc. I guess that's why he's in my law class. And Jason Tobin, A-K-O, or Akko, I'm not sure.
Akko.
Although many have heard Fuzzy Dice, this is their first actual appearance in front of people. I guess that means they've been performing in front of their friends up till now. This song is dedicated to all the women who could not be with us tonight. Reminds me of a Willie Nelson, Julio Iglesias song. To all the girls I've loved before. That's all they wrote. Now I gotta stall.
Go, sir.
All right, as you know, the music department's going to Texas this year. And the Houston Astrodome has artificial turf. You're probably wondering why that's the case. So the cheerleaders don't raise. The heat's getting to you. Just a minute longer. These aren't necessarily my jokes, of course. There's, some say there's capital punishment down in Texas. They have a peculiar law there. Do you think you can hang a man with a wooden leg? No, it's easier with a rope. Time to bring up Fuzzy Dice.
Well, good evening. We're Fuzzy Dice. We're Fuzzy Dice, and I don't know if Mr. Whitman told you everything in the middle of his rather impressive jokes. Well, we got together about a couple months back, and this is our first really performance in front of more than five people. So if you do us a big favor, could you please clap after we finish? It would make us feel a lot better. This is a song by Tom Petty. I think you'll all recognize it.
Bye.
What a night.
Thank you, boys. Musician's greatest fear is being on stage for 1 hour after two coffees and a bran muffin. For that reason, we're going to take a 15-minute break, and we'll come back. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the second half. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I feel like a teacher again. I just heard the senior concert band praying, and so we know it's time for them to perform with their conductor, Mr. Brian Tisdale. Piece was Amarillo Roca, which is a Spanish march. It's obvious why we're taking a Spanish march to San Antonio. The next piece is a tune that you know well, but you're going to hear a brand new arrangement. Every year, one or two OACs choose a non-performance project as part of their OAC credit. One of the projects could be arranging, and a young lady arranged Queen from Ice Castles. Her name is Marianne Allen. And all of us who completed the OAC tours would like you to hear it. She's done a wonderful job. Marianne Allen, Queen from Ice Castles. The piece we are going to play is the challenge piece that we will play at the Heritage Festival in San Antonio. It's entitled Inheritance by Alfred Reed. Thank you. I'd like to call Ms. Speciale and Mr. McAllister back up to issue dress passes to those students with those sweaters and to give out the senior proficiency awards. As you know, our program mixes very much the academic, the practical. We call ourselves a co-curricular program. We'd like to honor two students who have made a tremendous contribution over the 5 years that they've been in school, both for their academics in music, but also their playing and the contribution they've made to the band and the choir. First person we would like to congratulate, I think it's Miss Speciale, for for the top mark OAC grade 13, Janet Seal. There's another student who is about to do, well, as soon as we get back from Texas to do auditions, who's planning to go into a Bachelor of Music program, and some of us hope he may end up being a music teacher in a Catholic high school, I don't know. Mr. McAllister, I'd like to present the Leger Music Bursary to Jason Lill.
Sort of like to turn the tables around and give our teachers some gifts. There's four teachers that help out the music program, much more supported, any more supported. First one we'd like to thank is Mr. Whitman, our MC tonight. He's also the conductor of the Dixieland Band. Mr. Whitman around. The man with the line for everything. Thank you. The next teacher we'd like to thank is Ms. Corcoran, who helps out with the vocal class. Ms. Corcoran. Okay, the next is conductor of the junior band, Mrs. Tomchuk. Been here 2 years. Now the last person's kind of special because he has been at our school for 5 years now, and us being grade 13s have had him for 5 years. He's seen us as babies just entering the music program, and he's been with us 5 long years, and we've made him sweat those 5 years, and tonight he's making us sweat. In those 5 years, I think we've aged him about 20. So. They liked it in the music. Thanks a lot, Mr. Tisdale.
Now for the unsung heroes, the parents. As always, we pick the coolest night step concerts. We also pick special occasions and families, birthdays and whatever. Tonight there's an anniversary, and the parents are here celebrating their anniversary of their daughter's concert.
And I'd like to call Michaela De Stefano to come up, and she's going to introduce the next song and make the dedication.
Today, my parents, Jacqueline Eleanor De Stefano, are celebrating their 21st wedding anniversary, and I just wanted to say that I really admire all the love that they've shown each other for the last, 16 years since I've been around. The choir will sing When Beneath My Wings by Al Henry and James Sidlin. It won an Academy Award by Beth Midler, and this song is dedicated to the both.
Thank you.
actually wasn't the Leger Choir, that were the women of the Leger Choir, and I think they sang very, very nicely.
Class act.
They were Michael Wise, alias Peter Mansbridge, Jamel Espejo, alias Paul Anka, Wayne Tan, a wonderful guy, I know that because he's always telling me, and Scott Williams, a guy who can brighten a room just by leaving it. Just kidding. I'd like to call up our principal, Mr. Joe Moore, to present a couple special awards. And Mr. Brian Sisko.
Well, this is the last concert, our last home concert, for 20-some people this year. It's a very large group. They're finishing high school and going on to university and college. They have to work. Usually, we have 13 or 14, so we try to say some nice things about everybody, but it's hot in here, so I thought what I would do is perhaps do a little memory lane. They think that they know what goes on, and the teachers, of course, don't know much about what's going on, but let's just compare notes here. Parents, you can help me out. I guess we should start with the first few weeks in grade 9. And I know many of those 20-some students were making some very rude noises when they were taking their instruments home for the first time. And I'm sure you wondered what I was teaching them. I think that some of the memories they might have from that first year are being in a 100-piece junior band. That time we didn't have enough chairs, we had a lot of people standing. I think we did music camp that year. A few of you were invited to join the senior band because we only had one horn player, so I told three people, you're going to play horn and you'll be in the senior band next week. And you know what? They were in the senior band the next week. That's called progress. I think grade 9 and 10 were the years for braces. I remember kids becoming half-decent players. You and I both could tell that they were playing tunes, and then the dentist ruined it for us all. And there were a lot of tears, but you got through it. I think the practice rooms, they're supposed to be where I send them to practice, but believe me, all the problems of the world get solved there, and I just pretend I don't know what's going on. It's the best way. I think we probably remember all the tricks. I think we remember things like massive garage sales. You remember that, don't you, parents? Remember selling poinsettias. Boy, there were a lot of Christmas cakes one year. We did quite well on that sale. I think that you probably remember that in 1988 we were all getting ready to go to England, and I got a memo from the people in England saying that we were to march in an Easter parade, and I looked at my concert band and I said, oh my God. So I decided that on one Sunday, the Sunday before we left, we came into this gym and we learned how to be a marching band. It was a very interesting thing to see. Now, on that Easter parade, they just happened to position us behind a 150-piece professional U.S. marching band. And we were playing the same song over and over again. The Brits liked us, you know. They stopped us at one point. And the American marching band went over this big hill and down. And they were taking pictures. We were going to be in the local newspaper. Unfortunately, when I came up to the crest of the hill, we started to march again, and there was no parade in front of us because at the bottom of the hill, you know those little English towns, there was a fork in the road. And the road went that way, and that way, and that way, and that way. So I had to run around the block and find the parade so Leger's marching band could catch up. I think that at least a couple students remember that we do believe that when they go on a trip, they should have a cultural experience. That's why we made sure that at least a few of them got to learn what it was like to live on a sheep farm. I'll leave it to gentlemen to remember that situation. I remember one night there was a curfew at 11 o'clock, and I just remember running into three people. At least one or two of them were flute players. You can see them turning red right there.
And we were coming out across the park, and they stopped, and they looked at us and stopped dead, and thought, uh-oh, we're in trouble. I said, I guess you're going home, girls. They said, yes. Little did they know, we were trying to find out where the rest of them were, but we'd already scouted out the dance club, so we knew where they were. Unfortunately, these three young ladies, in their panic, the eyes darted across the street to this dance club. They went on their way, and we went up to the dance club. And I've never seen 500 young people run out of a club so fast in my life. The doorman was very upset with me. All I did is go to see this dance club. And we only had 100. I don't know where the other 300 came from. I think that I remember some other things, and things like dedication. I remember kids finishing football games, football practices. They were over about 6 o'clock, and band started at 6:30, and the kids who played football were there. I remember some young ladies playing on the volleyball and basketball teams. Sometimes the games went to 6:45, and band started at 6:30. They got off the bus, and in their uniforms, they came to band Wednesday night. I can remember interesting little things. I remember there's at least one student graduating that doesn't play concerts without wearing a scarf, and I still don't understand why not. Except I think tonight that person isn't wearing his or her scarf. These are just some of the memories that we have of you. And I want to tell you that from all the music staff, all the teachers at Leger, we've enjoyed it. We wish you the very best after you leave high school. Mr. Moore, I'd like to present to you the music students of Leger who are graduating this year and going on. First person, one of our first flute players, Marianne Allen. Alto sax player, Anne-Marie Picard. First clarinet player, Kimberly Beauchamp. Clarinet player, Donia Bloxham. Another alto sax player, Teresa Sata. And another sax player, a lot of sax players are graduating, Merle DaCosta. That lady who played bass clarinet for us up until Christmas, I don't know whether she's in the audience, Linda DeMello. You hear Linda? There she is. One of the flip sides. Fine singer, Jamel Espejo. Young lady has held a very important post, musical post, in our band, concertmaster and clarinet player, Sarah Galea. French horn player and sometimes trombone player, Eric Goodridge. First trumpet player and sometimes assistant head of the department, Catherine Jurisic. Our bass player, Junipero Lagapunk. Man played trombone for us up until Christmas, Mark Lapadula. Our lead trumpet player, Jason Lill. Young man sings in our choir as a bass, Rob McCauley. One of our first flute players, Don Marie Machado.
young lady who played flute for us, first flute until Christmas, Nikki Perso. Accepting for Nikki, Georgia Dill. First flute player, Susan Wright. One of those young ladies that we saw at the park that night. I just couldn't resist it. She'll never forgive me. Very fine singer, also an excellent horn player, Natalie Rodrigue. Our first flute player, Janet Seal. Young lady who played tenor sax for us up until Christmas, Colleen Tapp. Colleen? All except for Colleen. French horn player, tenor, member of the flip sides, Wayne Tan. Young lady who spent 4 years playing horn for us and now has become our third trombone player, Georgia Taylor. Young man who is officially not leaving Leger yet, but he'll be doing co-op in the fall. That means he won't be in school, so we're going to give him his award right now. Trumpet player Jason Tobin. First alto sax player, Scott Williams. And was our only baritone player, but now the lead baritone in the band, Michael Wise. Young man who's out to work now, but was our lead drummer up until Christmas, Joseph White. Young lady who played flute for, I believe, 3 years, now a member of the choir, Larissa Galadza. One more gentleman who is, I believe, graduating this year and hopes to go to Humber next year sometime soon, Stephen Ford. Last award of the evening is our special Leger Music Award. It's awarded to the graduating student who spent 5 years with us as a vocalist or instrumentalist or both, who has demonstrated musical excellence, has been a remarkable participator, and also has shown the qualities of Christian leadership. Now that's pretty high and mighty. That translates into if somebody's having a problem, that person helps them, and I think it's something that we've seen throughout in many of these students, almost all these students. Whenever somebody was a younger player or was having difficulties, these students were willing to help out. And it's an admirable quality as far as we're concerned. It was very difficult with that number of graduates. So many of you are deserving of this award. But we decided this year that the award, Leger Music Award, goes to Michael Wise.
Got a great staff, but I am also a dad, a teenager, and so I know that this whole thing kind of goes together. So I know that Mike was not accepting this by himself. Mom and Dad are here, and I'd like you to come to the whole family.
Well, it's been a hot night. We thank you for coming out. Like other years, I promise we'll take care of them in Texas. The final itinerary was faxed from Texas today. You'll have the last minute information on Monday. We'll finish our concert tonight with a tune that we played about 2 or 3 years ago, but we're going to take it and play it in one of our afternoon concerts in San Antonio, Broadway Spectacular.
Thank you.
To the band, nobody leaves till the whole place is clean. Thank you very much. God bless.